I have an illness. It's what you and mother call my moodiness. And it's getting worse and worse. It will be the end of everything unless I can do something about it. I'm sorry to bring you in on this, Frieda, but you're not blood family, and I don't seem to be able to get Dad alone.
Well, I feel like family. Goodness.
Dad, there's a lady, a doctor, and I've talked to her. She can help me in the pursuit of me, and she thinks that that's a useful pursuit.
Willard, you said yourself we have a perfectly good spare room, and all her things would fit in there just perfect.
Nothing will fit perfect anywhere until I fit perfect. I'm sorry.
I'm going to the restroom. I don't want it said that I influenced any.
Between the rock and the hard place, Sybil, you know how the church views the practitioners of the mind.
I'm very frugal. If I give up my luxuries, television, and I don't read after sunset, and I use the stove only occasionally to cook 3 days at a time, I could get by on what you send me.
Devil have power to assume a pleasing shape.
She's not the devil, Dad. Now, I know that.
I don't know that about anyone except the people in our own congregation.
She's a reputable doctor.
First thing you know, it's drugs. Then a hospital full of lost souls.
That's the way they begin
it,
Sybil.
I think I'm trapped.
Final preparation for the Holocaust.
It's Armageddon, Sybil. And it shall rise up in the east, and the river shall flow as blood.
I'm sorry. Oh, Dad, I'm sorry. I can pay for it. It surely is about $2.
What is the matter with you? Sybil! 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 Sybil!